Hi, I'm Sharad.
Hello, this is Avinash.
And I welcome you all to Inspiria TV. Today we have someone who is very enthusiastic. A travel blogger, a person who loves traveling, who loves clicking pictures and taking everyone in his camera and putting them on YouTube. Let's meet Mr. Simon Zielinski from Poland, 6,300 kilometers away from India. So how are you feeling, sir, coming here to Siliguri?
I'm feeling great. This is
a great place to be. I'm very happy that I'm in Inspiria College. And thank you for the opportunity of having a lecture. And so far it's been great. It's been fantastic. I enjoy it.
Great. So coming from so far, from Poland to India,
yeah.
What differences you feel regarding weather condition, regarding culture, whatever?
We never get such a hot weather as you have in Siliguri. In Siliguri, it's very hot and humid.
Yeah, recently it touched 41. So really? What about Poland?
Well, in Poland, in the summer, we get 23, 25. Once we get 30, but it never really gets humid. Like, never gets that humid. But in the winter, we get minus 20, minus 30 degrees. Okay. So it's very, very cold. So it's almost freezing temperatures.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Since you have traveled so many places, like, I want to know which country is your favorite.
Well, India is my favorite.
Oh, wow. So what makes you India, this favorite country?
Well, people, I think, in India. It's so far. Well, I've traveled many countries, and I think which country you like the most, it depends at what level you are in your life. Like, in the past, I had other favorite countries. Right now, at this moment, at this day, today at 4 p.m., when we're recording this interview, I like India the most. And what I like about India is the people. Very, very nice. Sometimes when I stay by myself at the side of the street and want to take the picture, people just come up to me and say, hello, where are you from, what are you doing? And we just keep on conversation. That's how we met, right?
Exactly.
So you believe that Indian people are much more supporting than any other country people?
Yes, I have good experiences from India, and I've never really feel alone when I'm traveling.
But I want to ask you something, like, yeah. Being in Poland, coming to India, you have been in several countries.
Yes.
Before you were in Sri Lanka, like,
yes.
Last 3 years back. So different cultures, different languages, as you know, India has so many languages. Yesterday we were laughing when we talked about wherever you go, you find different language. You don't understand whether
exactly.
It's what language it is, actually. So how do you manage to speak to them? How do you manage to know that culture?
Well, I think you cannot really know the culture. Like, when you go somewhere, for me, when I came here into Siliguri for the first time, I felt like a cultural shock. Because there were so many people, like the anecdote I said, in one day in Siliguri, I see as many people as I see in a whole year in my hometown.
that's I felt a cultural shock at the beginning.
Yeah. But it's my sixth, seventh time in Siliguri and in India, so I kind of know what to expect. And the more you travel, especially in Asia, you kind of get accustomed to the culture, to the sounds, to the smells, because it smells like differently. Like, if it's a hot weather, you get the smells like differently, right? In Poland, you wouldn't really feel so many smells, and sometimes I'm overwhelmed by the smells here. Like, there's so many, you know, like the baked food or some smells from the river, you know, and it's like sometimes I feel like I'm a little bit drunk in India, you know, because of the sounds, because of the people. And it's for you, it's normal, I guess, because you get used to it. But for me, it's like, whoa, so many things going at the same time. But going back to your question, how do I get, sometimes when English, I use English, but when my the people that I meet don't speak English, we use the sign language, and usually you can use the Google Translate or other apps that you have on your phone, and actually you can say something in English and it'll translate into the local language. But I think the more you travel, the more you go places, the more skills you acquire, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I would like to ask that, how do you prepare yourself before traveling to places?
I read. This is like, I try to read books about the place where I go. I try to read novels. I love reading novels. So I usually try to read some novels by the local people. But sometimes, you know, we lead such a life that is very chaotic, and you have so many things to do. And sometimes you don't really have any books to read before, or you don't really have time to read. So I kind of go with the flow. And usually when I'm in a hotel, I ask people like, what is interesting to do or what's interesting to see in this place
or in that place? How can I go from place
okay,
to place?
So you maintain that relationship with the manager.
Yeah, with the manager or with okay. all regular people that okay. I think the people that meet on your path are the most important
in your travels, because like when you go on an organized tour, you kind of get the idea or the view of your travel from the tour operator or from the tour company. But when you are traveling by yourself, you kind of, you're there by yourself, right? You are shaping day by day how your travel will look like. And tomorrow I'm going to Bhutan and I'm not really know how will my bus drive will look like. Or I was coming here to Siliguri from Gangtok and I was planned to be on the bus for 4 hours, but it took me 8 hours because there was a landslide after Gangtok. So we stood in a traffic jam for three and a half hours. So it was crazy. But that's what make the good memory, right? Yeah, in the exactly. future, it was kind of terrible, like being in a bus and it was raining and I got out and we were hungry. There were no toilets, so it was very tiresome at that moment. But right now, one day later, even I'm telling you as an anecdote, and we both smiling about it. So something, the inconvenience during travel is something fantastic when you look at it from a time perspective.
The next question is, I see you as a very independent person. Wherever you go, you are very independent. You take your camera along with you, you take everything inside that camera, you put them on YouTube. So according to a vlogger, what do you think that your video has something that differentiates other vloggers?
I think it has me. That's the most important thing, right? Like, I'm unique. Everyone is unique. Like, and all of us here in this room, there are many people. You probably don't see it, but there are many people in this room, and all of us are unique. So if we tell our stories, right? I tell my story, you tell your story, and you tell your story. So each our story would be different. So I think that's what makes me unique. And I'm not a big vlogger. Like, I do it for pleasure of creating. This is the thing that actually pushes me forward. I like to create things, and I've always liked to create things. So that's what I do on YouTube, and I do my recording and I do my editing and I do my sound levels and I do color correction. So I do everything by myself, and I think this is fantastic thing about new media. That
one man army equals to Simon.
No, everyone can do it. Like, I've never really, like, no one taught me how to do it. I've watched tutorials on YouTube and that's how I learn. I've read, you know, tutorials online how to do it, how to edit.
Very good reader, you search online things a lot.
I think maybe I'm interested in things. You know, when you are interested in things, you kind of put
your
time. Exactly. And it's not, the road itself, it's fun. Like, every edit or every video that I record, I've learned something new.
Great.
Right? Every time I see how to adjust the sound level, or I've learned a new transition trick. And it's a fascinating.
So everything was learned by yourself?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, I have a friend or two that kind of more advanced on the technological level. So if I struggle with something, I ask them and they tell me like, oh, you should do this or you should do that. But it's fun. I always like watching movies, and right now when I can make my own movies, it's great. And
great.
The other thing is that if you travel and you make a movie about your travels, you can see it in a year or in 2 years. It's like the snapshot of the movie.
Exactly. And you're making your viewers travel along
exactly.
with you.
Yeah.
Great. That's the greatness of a vlogger.
I think so. Yeah. My point of view, and maybe in the future, if I have kids one day, you know, they could see how I was traveling here in India or in some other place, and they could see how I saw the world, and maybe they could do something else, and maybe they would see the world differently.
Yeah? Okay. Since you travel from place to place, how do you maintain your recipes, and how do you keep yourself healthy?
I run. I enjoy running. Like, I started a couple of years ago, 3-4 years ago. I was overweight. I was gaining weight, at the time, 3-4 years ago, and I was smoking cigarettes, and it wasn't a good lifestyle. So I decided to run. It was very difficult at the beginning. I couldn't run for 100 meters or 200 meters, but every day, every other day, so I started to run more and more and more. So even here, when I'm on holiday, I try to run like 2-3 times a week, and that's what keeps me healthy. I think that's the secret. And when I'm traveling to more exotic countries, I take probiotics. It's the pills that actually make your internal, worms, like not the worms, like the in your intestines, there are all these different microbes, right? And to keep them happy, and especially because I'm from from Poland, and we have different microbes in our food and our water. So I always drink the bottled water, right? So this is the important thing. And I take probiotics and I run, and this is it.
I'd like to add something to his question.
Yeah.
You're from Poland,
yeah.
And you travel so many countries. So, like every one of us, we have our special food.
Okay.
Like I love dosa.
Okay.
South Indian food. You must also love. Yeah. So everyone has something special.
Yeah.
And when you go to Bhutan, especially.
Yeah.
Bhutan is a country where we don't find that variety food.
Yeah.
We have imadanchi. If you ever heard that food. Yeah. That's very common over there. You find it everywhere.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
People can have it 3 times a day. So. How do you maintain that recipe? Like when you don't get that food which you want to eat?
I like all kinds of food, and I like spicy food because it helps in India or in Sri Lanka or in Bhutan. So I don't really mind spicy food. I like spicy food. But after some time, I started to crave things that like I really like. I like cheese, different kinds of cheese. And in Sri Lanka or here, so far I could only get like the processed cheese or the sliced cheese. And there are so many varieties of cheese that I could get back home. So this is what I miss the most. I think the bread. I mean, I like Indian cuisine. It's great. You can get all different kinds, and sometimes you can get even European food like buns or the chicken puffs or egg roll or something. So I can eat those kind of things, but sometimes I really miss, from home. I think that's with everyone, right? Like if you travel, you go to some other place, you miss or you eat something. And I miss salads, like a Greek salad, salads with some iceberg lettuce and some. But let's not get into that.
Okay.
I'm starting to do.
Okay, so the next question would be, what special things do you carry in your backpack? Since you're a vlogger, mm-hmm. I want our viewers to know,
okay.
What do you carry in your bag? The special things like, the lapel, the camera.
Okay, yeah. So the first thing that I carry three things. I carry like three cameras, right? I carry a camera in my cell phone.
Okay.
So this is the one. I carry the camera, more portable one. This is, they say,
actually?
One is for the wind, like when you don't have this, it's like a wind muff. I think it's called wind muff. So if you don't have it and it's windy, you can hear the wind and you cannot talk. And with this one, I can speak when it's windy and it catches my sound. So this is the second camera, and it has really good image stabilization. So when I walk, if you have a camera with that image stabilization, the view will be shaky.
And please let our viewers know, what is the model number of this camera?
It's Canon G7X Mark II.
Okay.
And so I have this one, and sometimes when I'm interviewing, because for my travel videos, I like to interview people, so I have a bigger one, Canon 80D,
okay.
and I also have the lapel mic as well, so like this one. So when I'm interviewing someone, I give them the lapel mic and they speak to it, and I also have a directional microphone that's I use with my cell phone or with a bigger camera as well. What else is in my bag? Since I'm actively editing videos, so I have a laptop with me.
Okay.
And it's heavy, right? The laptop is like 1 or 2 kilograms, so it is heavy. So I have a laptop, I have an external drive to keep all the videos.
So the last question I'd like to ask you is, you came down to Inspiria,
mm-hmm.
from so far. How was this session to you? And how is this interview to you?
Oh, the session is great. The whole Inspiria experience is fantastic. I enjoy talking to people. I enjoy having conversation. And I had conversations with both the teachers and the students. And so it's great. I feel great. It doesn't really, it's almost the same as in Poland, like the reactions I get. Sometimes I plan a joke and I got the reply for the joke, you know. So it's kind of, there's not really, not too many differences, you know. Like you have a big projector and you have a microphone and you speak to people. And I think if you tell them interesting things, people would listen. And that's, yeah, and Inspiria has been very welcoming. I like the campus. I haven't really seen that much yet. We will go and see after this interview to see a bit more. And but like, yeah, everyone is great. I enjoy my stay here in Inspiria.
Great, totally great. It was to our pleasure to have you in our campus. Thank you so much, sir, for this interaction.
Thank you very much.
And we really hope to see you again in our campus, in the same beautiful manner.
Let's hope that we'll
thank you so much. This is me, Sharad Agarwal.
And this is me, Avinash Chutri.
And would like to sign off. Keep watching Inspiria TV.